Hi everybody, this is Master Yoo, US National DahnMuDo Trainer. This time, I'd like to help some of you has the difficulty of the hip and knee joint. It will help you to stimulate and then loosen up the hip and knee joint. And also, you will improve the strength of your lower back and quadriceps, and along with your shin muscles. Once you have a limitation on your hip joint and knee joint and ankle joint, you have the difficulty to bend down or sit down, even the rotations. Because this is the all rotation, squat and sitting, relying on your lower body. You can easily do with the hands, even turning, picking up. But the bending forward and back, stepping, turning, you have a limit. When your body condition is poor, check yourself which part you feel uncomfortable, mostly on your legs. The leg is heavy and leg is stiff and tight. Those is the result from the stagnant energy on your hip joint, knee joint. The joint is the holding the more stagnant energy than your muscles. When blood flows close to the joint, their blood arteries are getting tender to be narrowed. Due to this narrowing, it may attract the many stagnant energy on your knee and hip joint by stimulating with the proper posture and respiration and supporting with your guidance. We can say the concentration. You may expect some of the benefits. But please use your caution if this is the too much intensive, and you can use gently. You need to modify yourself. Okay? So prior to practice this training, we have to do one thing to stimulate your Achilles. Okay? So put your heels together, toes apart just a little. Okay, heel should be sealed. Pick up your heel up in the sky. At that time, so try to grip the ground by use of 10 toes. You may feel a little wiggling. Instead of the step to catch the balance, try to use more your toes and shin muscle and thigh and abdomen and back. That is the muscle usually work together to get the balance. Now slowly down, but don't touch the heel on the ground, and up. Okay, squeeze your kneecaps by use of quadricep muscle, and then slowly down and up and down. You may feel some of your toe joint and replace some cracks, and up and down, stimulating your shin muscle along with your Achilles. Great! You can use this one about 20 to 30 times. Then prepare for this training to strengthen and stimulate your hip and knee joint. Feet apart, shoulder width apart. Great. Next, dragging your right side big toes behind of you. You see one side the leg is the heel is on the ground. The other one is the heel is up. Old way. Old way is better, not this way. You have to shift your body weight all the way to your left. Okay, now tuck your right side knee behind of the other knee. Now, slowly open your left palm. From there, turn your core. Now you start to feel the high stimulation on hip joint, on your knee joint. But if this is too difficult to you, you may narrow the distance from the heel, narrows. Do not overdo it, may result the difficult situation for you. If that's okay, you can step further. Squat. Now from there, turn your body to your left, a little more. We pause this motion about 10 seconds. Now bring your palms in. Return your right foot. Yes, okay, you start to feel the high stimulation. Also, it's strengthening your quadriceps and your shin, calves, Achilles as well. Next one. Other side. Bring your right toes, left toes behind of you. Depending on your condition, the further you can challenge it, but if you have a difficulty, recommend narrow like this. Okay? We return. Place your right palms away. Relax your shoulders and elbow. Bend your wrist as much as you can. Now, from there, turn toward the right side. From there, sinking a little bit. Start to feel the hip joint and knee joint. We can pause a little bit. 10 seconds. And bring your palms in. And return. Great. You can repeat this one about 3 times this side and 3 times this side. If 10 seconds is too long, don't overdo it. Maybe hold 5 seconds. Even that is too hard, 3 seconds. Start with a small piece of the rocks. When these rocks gathering together, you can create a big mountain. Okay, so start with a small effort, improve your condition along with your confidence, then you can challenge it little by little. Once you're getting better at it, you can use this as a flowing motion. Okay, you can follow me slowly. 1, 2, 3, and back in. As it comes, other goes. 1, 2, 3. And as it comes, another goes. 1, 2, 3. Back in. Switch side. Relaxly down. And rise. Bend the wrist. Back in. Relaxly down, your feet and hands goes together, and back. Step, flow, sink, return. One more. Return. Last one more. And returns. Yes. You can repeat this training with a little bit holding pose, about 10 seconds. And then once you feel the accumulate of the energy, and then use the second method to circulate all the your energy side to side. Okay, so great. I hope you gained some benefits from this day. Hip joint, knee joint, strengthening and stimulation training. Thank you for watching.